new study shows how sugar might fuel the growth of cancer.
A new study finds pizza is the most addictive food in America.
A major new study finding up to 90% of cancers are not caused by genetics.
And a surprising new study out of Harvard today that could change the way we think about dieting.
A new study shows late night snacking could...
Where do all these scientific studies come from? What do they actually look like? We hear about them all the time, but rarely from the scientists themselves. Unfortunately, these quick and dirty TV pieces and articles are often inaccurate and misleading. If only we could look at the studies directly and see for ourselves. Lucky for us, this is the age of the internet, and this phenomenal trove of information is out there for anyone to find. If you know where to look and what to look for, it is all just one click away. Meet Google Scholar. It's a search engine, just like Google, but specialized for academic work, things like studies, articles, books, and it gives you access to most of the resources used by professional scientists. Looks super simple, right? But the information you find here can be literally life-changing. Let's say I'm interested in a certain disease. Maybe somebody in my family has diabetes. Okay, so I'm going to search, and we get a list of all the scientific papers talking about diabetes. Now, don't get intimidated if you see words you don't understand. Totally normal. Even professional scientists, it happens all the time. I've been searching scientific literature for almost 20 years now, since I was in med school, and it still happens all the time, especially papers outside my field. Lots of terms and techniques I'm not familiar with, no big deal. I look it up, or the paper itself often explains what the terms mean. So don't sweat it, it gets easier. You don't need a degree or formal scientific training to peruse this information and learn about your health. And why bother with Google Scholar in the first place? Why not just go straight to Google? Well, because of reliability. On Google, you're gonna find everything on the internet, but you're not gonna know whom to trust. I could make a website tomorrow saying the most outrageous things. Tobacco doesn't cause cancer, vegetables are horrible for your health, and somebody looking at the website who didn't know any better wouldn't have a way to distinguish what's real and what's not, because there's no oversight on a regular website. Here you're getting scholarly work, so there's going to be many layers of quality control over just regular Google hits. Now, this search is too general, so you get too many hits, over 2.5 million papers talking about diabetes. So maybe you want to search for something more specific. Maybe you want to know what foods lower and what foods increase your odds of getting diabetes. So you type maybe diabetes diet, and now we get a more restricted list of hits. Now, you don't necessarily want to click the title because that often does not give you full access to the paper. You want to go for this link on the right over here. That's always full text access. So here we are. This is the full paper, all the results, all the discussion by the authors. It's amazing that we get access to this information so easily, for free basically. So you can go through, see what the authors did, see what they concluded. And you've got this little summary over here, the goals, the results, and the conclusions that they drew. Now, what about the second hit? It doesn't have a full text link. And in fact, what you see if you click the title, it only gives us the summary of the work and not the full text. So are we stranded? Does this mean we can't look at the full work? Not necessarily. That's where this other tool comes in, this nifty little website called Sci-Hub. And what you're going to do is you're just going to copy this URL right onto this search box right there and click open. And here we are. A lot of times this works and it gives you access to the full text, all the discussion by the authors, all the results, etc. So by combining Google Scholar and this Sci-Hub tool, you end up getting full text access to a lot of the research out there. Let's see another example. Let's go back to the homepage of Google Scholar. Let's say you saw some interesting headline or you heard some news on TV, something that caught your attention and you want to fact check it. Maybe you heard something about red meat and cancer. Okay, you want to check that on Google Scholar, and here we are. All the studies that talk about red meat and cancer. So you can go through, maybe You look at the first half dozen or the first dozen, and you get a rough idea of what the science is saying. So let's take a quick look at the first hit. Carcinogenicity of consumption of red meat and processed meat. So you can go through this, see what the author said, and so on down the list. But Google Scholar is not just for medicine and biology. In fact, you can search any scientific topic on here. Let's say you heard something on the news about climate change and you want to get informed. So you search climate change and almost 3.5 million hits on scientific papers on climate change. If you want to make the search a little more specific, maybe add man-made climate change. And here are all the papers. Now you see it's gone down to less than 500,000. You get the idea. As you narrow the search, you get more and more specific hits. Or you can search for natural disasters and the connection with, I already have the search here, all the papers that talk about climate change and natural disasters. You can see what the scientific consensus is. So this is a great, great tool to fact check. You hear something about nutrition in a blog or a YouTube video, and normally you don't have a good way to distinguish what's phenomenal information and what's just nonsense. One source says A, one source says B. You're stuck. You either give up or you just trust whoever has the most degrees or whoever appears most friendly to you. There's no way for you to clearly distinguish fact from fallacy. So that's where Google Scholar comes in. Even a quick search can give you a pretty decent first pass idea of what scientists are saying about a topic that you're normally not going to get from mainstream media because it just doesn't go deep enough. Of course, this is not going to make you an expert overnight, but it's a great tool to fact check some information and to protect yourself and be empowered. At the end of the day, you don't need a degree to learn more about your health and about medicine. You just need a bit of curiosity and access to great information.